We have the man who's become America's newest screen idol. Starring in the movie that's sweeping the country, Bob Ross. He's the first white musician ever to fit in with the cut clipboard. Give a warm round of applause for Harlem's own Dixie Boyer!
Hey, guys.
Tom Waits é um compositor que a gente pode chamar de selvagem. Apesar de atuar de corpo e alma no showbiz, ele mantém os seus sapatos no underground e a cabeça no céu. Logo que ele chegou para a nossa entrevista, ele demorou uns 10 minutos para sentar. Ele parecia inquieto, muito incomodado com as câmeras. Mas aos poucos ele foi sentindo confiança e finalmente sentou e nos deu essa estranha e divertida entrevista que vocês vão ver agora.
You are a songwriter, a poet, an actor. Do you think you put your whole soul, you know, your whole self in everything you do?
Sometimes, not every time. Sometimes you're all out of Tabasco sauce.
Spicy.
The more Tabasco, you gotta go
on fire.
Yeah.
And sometimes, just a soup, a plain soup.
Just a nice plain soup with a little bit of pepper. Nice little napkin and a silver spoon.
Sometimes very clean. Sometimes diving in the dirt.
In the soup.
In the Tabasco.
Right off the spoon and into the soup. Sometimes, what were we talking about?
Tabasco, spicy things, the hot times.
Yeah.
We are talking about the heat.
Okay, the heat, yeah.
You know, you had a lot, you had lots of jobs. Waiter,
yeah.
Pianist in the Tropicana Motel. What are your memories of this period?
Well, you see, that was a hotel that was, you know, really a businessman's hotel when it started out. It was a $9 a night motel for like Fuller Brushman and people who were been on the road for... It wasn't really a music hotel when I first came there, although it had been in the early 60s. But, it had fallen into this kind of... I don't know, the people who used to stay there were... Yeah, people, well, $9 a night is going to attract a certain crowd. Slowly it got a reputation for bands. A lot of bands started staying there. And I had a place in the back, and I was very happy back there. Fresh towels, clean-up maids. It was very nice. They painted the swimming pool black was the last thing I remember they did there.
A black swimming pool is something?
A black swimming pool, yeah. That's like painting your teeth black so you don't have to brush them anymore. And I knew that it was really finished for me there.
You said that's enough.
That's enough.
I can't stand it anymore. That's the drop, the last drop.
That was the last drop of Tabasco.
Yeah.
For me, yeah.
And then?
I moved to New York and I lived in a lot of different places.
Mm-hmm. And have you been through really, really rough times in your life?
Lots of different kinds of times. Good times, bad times.
Rough?
Like everybody else. Yeah, I've been through some rough times.
What is a rough time?
Pow.
Pow?
Well, some of them were rough at the time, but as I remember them, they're actually kind of funny.
Because you said, I like things that are kind of falling apart. Do you feel that about yourself sometimes?
That I'm falling apart?
We all feel
right
that.
Right here on the show.
Now here you are.
I'm okay.
Wonderful.
Falling apart. Well, you know, when you come from a broken home, I think you're always going to be attracted to things that are also broken. you're going to want to find something that's broken and try and put it back together. You're going to feel sorry for that broken radio or that broken guitar. You know, you will. You just, you know.
You will feel sorry, but are you going to try to fix it?
Yeah. Or?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Huh.
So, that's normal.
You went through a self-destructive period in your life, and, you know.
Gee, I don't know. Yeah, I guess perhaps I did. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, but, yeah.
I mean, alcohol, drugs, you know.
Everything, baby.
You tell me.
I'm going to tell you right here where the camera's running, all the terrible things I did. You turn off the cameras and I'll tell you what.
Okay, let's do it right now. Turn it off. Your lyrics talk about suicide, murder. How far do you allow yourself to go?
Not far enough.
I know you're still here.
Well, I think you have to let down the, you know, the biggest drawback to making these things really work is yourself. You really have to face your own inability to go forward. I think in stories and in songs, you get a little scared sometimes, or you're uninhibited, or you're nervous or worried, or you don't want to go too far from home, and just like when you're a kid. You know?
Mm-hmm.
How far? I used to like fly a kite. I would get the kite till it was this big in the sky. I had like thousands and thousands of feet of string until the kite would disappear, and I could barely.
You've been taking the risks to have it disappeared.
Yeah, and then like.
Cut.
And then I go look for it.
Mm.
And I go everywhere. I go 10 miles away into everybody's backyard, people I didn't know, and there were dogs that I didn't know, and there were strange neighborhoods, and I was just looking for my kite.
Mm-hmm.
And I found it sometimes. It was a big thrill to find a kite that was that small in the sky. I felt.
After cut it.
Yeah.
And purple.
Yeah.
You're, in this album, there are so many references to death.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever come very close to suicide?
Me?
Well.
I've thought about it. Everybody's thought about it. What would it feel like? For people who are very depressed, thoughts of suicide are like erotic thoughts. These are the thoughts you toy with that make you very excited. The idea of ending it all, you know, it's very thrilling. It can be this fast. About it from a dramatic standpoint. I don't think if I had really been thinking about it, it already would have happened.
You would try.
I never tried.
Mm-hmm.
No, I. But I think about it.
And murder.
Além de músico, Tom Waits é um ator. E ele fez muito sucesso em filmes como Down by Law, do Jim Jarmusch, e o último do Hector Babenco, Brincando nos Campos do Senhor. O nosso encontro no seu estúdio, no meio de um campo da Califórnia, foi repleto de pausas e climas. Mesmo sem estar atuando, Tom Waits se mostra um personagem dos mais interessantes.
Ah!
That hurt. He's in the vat. We're gonna have to shut it off, let it cool down. It could take all night.
You're in my way now, Buck. You talk real nice to Kenny. You hear me? Are you gonna go in that vat with enough lead and you'll make you sink?
And murder.
Murder, no, I... Oh, well, you know, I thought about murder, too. The idea of murdering a stranger, though, has always seemed ridiculous. That if you're going to murder someone, it should be a family member. Because you know? You have all these pent-up, you know, resentments and anger towards people in your family, and that if you're going to really do the big one, it shouldn't be someone you don't know. It should be someone you can really communicate with. You've had an ongoing thing, and finally, you know.
Shakespeare, great Greek tragedies.
Mm. I'm not encouraging that. You just asked me, and I'm just...
Yeah, because, you know, you talk about this. Yeah. So, is he in your thoughts?
Yeah, it's in my thoughts.
Have you ever been in therapy? No. What for?
You mean have I gone to a psychiatrist?
Yeah, a shrink, you know, someone to talk.
Yeah, I've been to a shrink.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
But it was expensive.
Oh, for very sure. They're very expensive. Yeah, you solve your problems, but you got, you know, completely broken.
Bartenders are much cheaper.
What do you do when you want to escape? I mean, when you really want to get away from it all?
You know what I do? I get up to about 90 on a wet road that's curving at night, and then I turn off the lights and slam on the brakes. The kids love it. They scream, they spin around.
So. Oh, God. And when you went to the shrink, could you define, you know, the line between the insanity and that sort of balance that they try to sell it?
I don't know where the line is.
Do you?
I think that you go there so that they will draw the line for you. And you know the difference between...
And do you know?
My line is... it is. And then you can change the line anytime you want.
You can cheat on it sometimes.
Yeah. Erase the line.
Have any dream that something, any thought that you would like something, you know, you imagine you're doing?
Look, going into space with a band. I'm going to write that up as a proposal. I don't know what I would like to do that I'm not... I like to think that I can pretty much do what I would like, and if it occurs to me, I could find a way to make it happen. But dreaming of something don't know.
Maybe you don't have any.
I'm going to think about it, and then you have to come back.
I will.
Some of these things are hard to...
I promise I'll come back.
Okay.
And what can't you leave without?
My wife, my kids, mm-hmm. my family.
And what can't you leave with?
A dog.
Oh, yeah?
Well, we got rid of the dog. It was terrible.
Yeah, talking about your wife, she co-wrote the songs with you. How does it work, you know, your relationship working together?
It's great, really. It's to collaborate with someone, you have to come from totally different backgrounds, and otherwise one of you is unimportant mm-hmm. in the collaboration. She's a lapsed Catholic. She's from Illinois. She grew up on a farm, and so she has her background in music is from her own. She invented herself from church music and Irish music, and
mm-hmm.
She has her own mythology and has changed the way I hear music, because when I started working with her, I think she changed the way I hear things and see things, and I think
mm-hmm.
has had a very big effect on the way I hear music, and so I think we complement each other. And,
but how has she influenced you?
Made me more rhythmic, more fearless, more percussive, making instruments, the idea of make your own instruments. You don't have to play that if you don't like that. Make one yourself. Make one that sounds better. This sound. Put that in the song. Do what you want. Have courage. Be bold. Be like a wizard. Be like Dr. Frankenstein. Make what you want. Wait for the storm. Put the wires on his neck and he'll get up and walk. And I believe it.
Weren't you before?
Wasn't I? Before, I think, you see, I think that, you know, we all grow, and hopefully we grow strong, not always straight,
mm-hmm.
but we grow stronger and then develop more courage about what we want to do with music or whatever. And before, I think I was more scared, and I was like an old man in the corner with too much wine.
You know?
And
so you've changed a lot since you met her.
Oh, yeah. Good, in good ways.
How long ago?
12 years.
So this marriage seems to have changed you, really. And
Yeah.
Have you mellowed?
Well, you see...
Just tell him it's Pony Boy and Johnny, man. He'll come. Come on.
E agora com vocês, a última parte dessa nossa entrevista com o músico, ator e poeta Tom Waits.
Have you mellowed?
Well, you see, I don't know. I don't really like to think of myself as having mellowed, but mellow is usually the word that it's when, I don't know, it usually means that you've quieted down, and I think I'm getting louder.
No, I don't think you are quieted down. You are so restless, you know. You are always in the creative process. You can't stop. Is it easy to work with her? I mean, you discuss how it works.
Yeah, we discuss everything. With music, you need sometimes someone just to push you.
Mm-hmm.
Push you into the water. You have to go. You need someone also to be able to say to you, this is shit that you wrote. This is nothing.
Yes.
You wrote this 1,000 times. This is really just...
Don't repeat
trash.
It.
Get rid of it.
And you listen to her.
You have to respect someone enough to know that they're giving you constructive criticism. And I do the same for her.
Sure. You've been married 3 times.
I've been married 3 times.
Am I wrong? Did I miss something?
No, I don't know who told you I was married 3 times.
No?
No.
More?
I've only
less?
Been married once.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No, no other women in it?
No.
No?
No. Right out of... No.
Maybe you forgot your...
But. No, I didn't forget. No, married 3 times. Who told you that was married?
Oh, I don't know. Who cares?
Where did that come from?
When did you find out the poetry, you know, that you could write, your feelings and...
I've been writing songs for a long time. But my early songs, I can't even listen to my early songs. I said, like, baby pictures for me.
Wow.
And then I got more mature. Just because, like, so very naive, if you look at the things that you wrote when you were very, very young, you say, well, this is so naive and, you know.
Innocent.
Yeah. Mm. That was before I had my bioflesh regenerator. And now that I've got my bioflesh regenerator, I'm capable of much more.
I'm another man.
Yeah. I like my coffee in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
I make the coffee. That's always a big moment.
What time?
About 7.
Mm-hmm.
What do I like to do?
So, do you wake up early in the morning?
Oh, yeah.
How is your daily, your routine? What do you do?
I go out and dig around the yard, look for bones, water the rose bush. Every day is different. Lately, I've been, doing a lot of stuff. I'm working lately, so I haven't had much time to sleep in and all that.
What time do you create?
Morning.
In the morning?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
My recording sessions are always about 10 o'clock in the morning. Everybody hates it but me.
Mm.
But I think this is the best time because everyone's clean and everyone's empty.
Yeah.
And open.
I want to say thank you.
Oh.
Thank you for your interview and your song.
Okay.
And the moment.
Okay.
In the Coliseum. presidential hall. All dead senators splashing in the blood. Thoughts are having someone with screaming in the mud. In the Coliseum. In the Coliseum.
Rede Manchete apresentou Bruna Lombardi em Gente de Expressão. Uma produção Jean-Pierre Manzon. Um oferecimento.